My name is Peppi Karppinen. I am professor of medical biochemistry in University of Oulu, and I'm dean for the Faculty of Biochemistry and Molecular Medicine. My favorite subject at school was mathematics. And when I was at the age of thinking of what I want to become, my first idea was a lawyer's career. And I don't know how mathematics and law would go hand in hand, but at the end, I was in a situation that I decided I wanted to stay in Oulu, my hometown, and I had to choose from the opportunities that the local university offered, and law was not one of them. And that's when I became more interested in medicine. And I applied to medicine and was accepted to the med school. I attended a course called medical biochemistry. And there I had a professor who had done his career in studying collagen and gelatin synthesis. He gave us excellent lectures. He explained us what a career in basic science is. And finally, he offered positions for two students to join his research group. I was very lucky to get accepted. Then I started doing scientific research along the medical school, and that really then became my career. So when I finished medical school, I practiced medicine a little bit, but science was really my passion, and I returned to the lab where I have been now more than 25 years. Something that really inspired me about doing basic science in the laboratory was that it is very similar to being a detective, which was as a child one of my favorite occupations. So we do not really know what we're after, but we have tools and we have hypotheses, and those guide us, and every day we find something new. In 2007, I had the opportunity to join the Nobel laureate Bill Kalin's lab at Harvard Medical School to carry out a postdoctoral period in his laboratory. And after that, I returned to University of Oulu, where I established my own research group. And now my group consists of 12 scientists and technicians. This is my fourth year as the dean of Faculty of Biochemistry and Molecular Medicine in University of Oulu. And what that means is that about 50% of my working time is administrative tasks. So I direct the faculty. It's a really international and fascinating environment to work in. Besides of that, I'm professor of medical biochemistry, which means that I get to teach the young students in medical school my subject, medical biochemistry. And then I lead my own research group, and we study the hypoxia response, enzymes regulating it. And our research topics are metabolic dysfunction and neurodegenerative diseases and cancer. One of the most wonderful things about my work is to work in a group of scientists and to be able to guide the young scientists in their career. Also, I'm very highly motivated in teaching in the medical school. I get to interact with the selected population of students that are highly motivated. And something that is very motivating in my work, that it is very multi-sided. So I have an administrative task, I have a scientific task, I have a teaching task. And it appears that every day when I come to work, I cannot predict what's ahead of me. I think in the future, it is very important that science renews and we will have new, young, talented scientists in the STEM field. And that's why I see promotion of the careers of younger scientists as a key for success in the future. Scientifically, my goal in 10 years is that we would have no treatment options for metabolic syndrome that utilizes our knowledge in the hypoxia response. As the Faculty of Biochemistry and Molecular Medicine, we train the next generation. It is very important that we succeed in training them and offering them the possibilities to have a successful career in the field of biochemistry in the future. I had the best doctoral thesis supervisor a woman can have. Kari Kivirko, a male, was highly supportive for female careers in science. So I've never felt that it was a downside to be a woman in science, actually quite the opposite. And then later, I have had the privilege to have an excellent female supervisor who has been an excellent role model of showing that there are no glass ceilings for women in the STEM field. As it has been scientifically proved that in any field, an equal gender balance benefits the field and the success of the field. So I feel that the same really applies also to the STEM field. So it's very important to have an equal gender balance of females and males working in the field. The STEM field is a highly exciting field. I hope I have convinced you that this is like being a pioneer or being a detective, and I cannot think of a more exciting area to work in. And this is not really a gender issue. The girls will do as fine as boys in this field. So if you are interested in mathematics or biology or chemistry or physics, this is really something that you should exploit and take the advantage. This is a great field to work in.